Hi, my name is Geshe Michael Roach. I grew up in the United States, and then I was lucky to attend Princeton University. Halfway through my studies at Princeton, I got a telephone call about my mother, that my mother had passed away suddenly. And then I sort of lost my interest in school, I lost my focus, and I went to India looking for a spiritual path. I ended up studying with the Tibetans. I attended a monastery, a Tibetan monastery, and I stayed there for 25 years. And I finished the course of study there, which is called a Geshe. The final examination for the Geshe is about 3 weeks of very intense debating and public examinations. And then when I finished, I was successful to finish. I was the first Westerner to finish at my monastery, the Geshe degree. And then my teachers asked me, we'd like you to do an extra part of an examination, an extra examination. Then I said, what is the extra examination? And they said, well, we would like you to go to New York, and we would like you to start a business, and we would like you to use the principles of mental seeds and karma, which you learned in the monastery, and we want to see if you can use those principles in order to make a successful company. And then we will donate all the money to the Tibetan refugees. So I agreed, and I went to New York City. I started a business, I helped to found a business, a diamond business called Andine International, and it became one of the fastest growing companies in the history of New York. It reached $250 million in annual sales, and it was recently purchased by Warren Buffett, who is one of the wealthiest men in the world. Then a lot of people began asking me, how did you do this? You know, you don't have any training. You were brought up in a monastery. You don't know anything about business. How did you make one of the fastest growing companies in America based on the ancient principles that you found in the texts and the ancient training in the monastery? So I began to give talks, and people began to come to the talks. I wrote a book called The Diamond Cutter. And then I'm coming to Japan. The Diamond Cutter book was recently published in Japan, and a lot of Japanese friends have asked me to come to Tokyo. I'll be there on October 21st, which is a Friday. I'll be speaking in the evening at 7 p.m. at Temple University, and we'll be giving a program called Ancient Tips for Modern Mastery. Really, what it will be is a talk about how you yourself can become successful by using the same principles that I used, that I was taught in the monastery. I think people want three kinds of success. I think it's good to have financial success. People would like to have enough money in their life, enough money to do all the things they want and not worry about things. Many people would like to have a beautiful relationship, and you can use the same principles to have a good relationship, a very perfect relationship. And then, of course, to enjoy a relationship and to enjoy financial success, you have to have good health. So I'll be talking about these three goals. I would call that mastery of one's life. And the higher goals, after we achieve financial success, health, and a good relationship, then naturally we want to see the same things for everyone in the world. We want to try to make the world a better place, a more peaceful place, and a place where there's no poverty or hunger. So all of these things can be achieved through the ancient principles that I learned in the Tibetan monastery, which I call the Diamond Cutter Principles. So I hope to see you there in Tokyo on October 21st in the evening at Temple University. And really what I would like to do is share these ideas with you and help you become a success in every part of your life. Hope to see you then.